Coming up, Emily Martinez from WEBN breaks down Monday's marathon for us.
And the EVVYs Gala brought glitz and glam to Emerson on Sunday night. Sam Morris will give us the latest.
And the Treble Makers join us for an in-studio a cappella performance.
All that and much more this morning, April 16th on Good Morning Emerson.
Good morning, Emerson. I'm Caroline Reese.
And I'm Ella Schaefer.
Now we have reached the last week of Good Morning Emerson for the season.
And this is Caroline's last week of GME ever because she's graduating this year. Not to make
this all sad. Not to make this sad. That's for Thursday.
Tears are for Thursday.
Not today. We have a great show for you today. We're going to actually start off and head down to the JPC where our WEBN correspondent, Emily Martinez, has the latest from the long weekend. How are you, Emily?
I'm doing good, guys. Good morning, and welcome to this WEBN News Update. I'm Emily Martinez here with today's top stories. Yesterday marked the 128th Boston Marathon. The 26.2-mile run is a signature Patriots Day event here in the city. Sese Lema from Ethiopia won the men's category. Helen Obiri won her second Boston Marathon in a row in the women's category. For the first time in history, a British person won a Boston Marathon title. Eden Rainbow Cooper won in the women's wheelchair division. Over 26,000 runners competed over $1 million in prizes. A man fell out of a second-story window from an apartment in Austin at a party during the Boston Marathon. Police were called to break up a large party mostly made up of Boston University students. Ambulances came and took the man to the hospital with a neck brace. Marathon Monday is known as a big party day for college students, and hours after the accident, students were back partying until 4 p.m. The identity and condition of the man is still unknown. On Saturday night, Iran launched over 300 drones and missiles at Israel. Almost all of the weapons were intercepted by Israeli and U.S. air forces. Officials say the attack was a response to an alleged airstrike from Israel earlier this month, where 7 of Iranian officials were killed. Israel is currently deciding how they will respond. After the attack, Biden made clear that the U.S. would not participate in any offensive action to Iran. Over a call with Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, Biden said he should consider Saturday night a win. Biden and his officials believe an attack would only lead to a regional war. He held an emergency meeting with 7 other countries on Sunday afternoon to coordinate a response to Iran. Here in Massachusetts, many officials have spoken out about Iran's attacks on Israel. Consul General of Israel to New England, Maureen Rubin, spoke with Governor Healey to ensure the safety of New England. Law enforcement has been focused on houses of worship and events leading up to Marathon Monday. New England officials said they will keep an eye on the Middle East and increase security if needed. That's all for today's WEBN News Update. Hey, Caroline and Ella, did you watch the marathon yesterday?
Yeah, I did. It was such a special day. And we were talking about this, just how like lively the city gets. Everybody is so into it. Did you get to see it?
Yes, I was at Fenway where I saw Ella.
Yes, I actually did see Emily yesterday, where Sam Lawrence and I were also filming a package for a class. So I was like, oh my goodness.
Emerson Journalism out in the field.
Yes. Well, thank you, Emily.
Yes, of course.
Runners in yesterday's marathon got lucky with sunny skies and warm temperatures. Well, let's head outside to the Common where Sabrina Lamb has this week's weather for us. How's it going out there, Sabrina?
Good morning, everyone. I'm currently outside in the Boston Common, and it's looking like it's going to be a pretty nice day out. It was such a bright, beautiful day outside yesterday for the Boston Marathon, and it looks like that weather will continue on to today and potentially for the rest of the week. Looking at today's forecast, we'll be experiencing a high of 64 degrees. Now, right now, it's more at an upper 50s, but those temperatures will gradually increase as we move into mid to late afternoon. Overcast will be coming in here and there, but will remain pretty light, and moving into nighttime, we'll be seeing mostly clear skies. Looking into the rest of the week, there will be highs in the 50s that will sometimes tip into the lower to mid 60s, and the lows will remain pretty consistently in the 40s range. Looking at the week's forecast, it's also looking like it's going to be mostly sunny. Our only day of any precipitation will be Saturday, with some on and off light showers here and there during the day, but that will dissipate into nighttime with mostly clear skies coming in. The warmest days this week are today and Saturday, but the coldest day this week will be Thursday, with the high reaching of a flat 50 degrees. Now, it looks like despite the light rains on Saturday, most of the week will be pretty sunny. There will be very minimal overcast coming in, so it looks like now maybe finally the time when we can start adding more fun outdoor activities to our schedule, like going for a nice stroll in the public garden or a long bike ride downtown. All right, that's all I have for weather. Back to you, Ella and Caroline.
Well, thank you so much, Sabrina, and thank you for being with us. Thank you for a great season.
Oh yeah, I forget we only see Sabrina on Tuesdays, so that's the last time we'll see Sabrina.
Yeah,
but we love her.
We do.
Yes. All right, Caroline. So this morning I was in the dining hall for breakfast. I know you love breakfast.
I'm a breakfast girl.
But one of my favorite breakfast foods is cereal, actually.
Cereal's underrated.
The dining hall happens to not have the best options.
No.
So it's like, I feel like you have to have a favorite sweet and a favorite like more mild,
like
cereal.
Savory. Yeah.
So like mine is Apple Jacks for like the sweeter side, and then my other one is Raisin Bran, which I think is really funny because I'm like an old lady.
Raisin Bran.
I like it. I don't know.
Ella.
And I like the brand Raisin more than the
Raisin Brans. No, I can't. I'm not a Raisin Bran.
Okay, what's your
order? No, I think if I were just to go with one cereal, Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
That's a good one.
Because then the milk gets like really like cinnamony too. And it tastes so good. Now I'm craving Cinnamon Toast Crunch. I probably haven't had it in months because the dining hall never has it, but looks like I'll be going out to get some Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
As you should.
An elementary school in the South Shore turned breakfast into a charity act. Vinyl Elementary School in Norwalk collected nearly 1,200 cereal boxes to donate to local food pantries. But to celebrate their big collection, a game of dominoes was played down the halls of the school.
Boxes across just Norwalk.
The school says the idea came from the school's student government community as a way to give back in a fun and creative way.
That's so lovely, Caroline. And the MSPCA has taken in 14 dogs from overpopulated New York City animal shelters in order to get them adopted at a fee-waived event this weekend. The dogs, which are mostly bigger bully breed mixes, will be available to adopt during the MSPCA's Ready, Set, Dog event, which will run from the 15th through the 21st of April. The furry friends came from Animal Care Centers of New York, which runs many shelters around the city that are above capacity. Besides the 14 coming from New York, lots of dogs from Massachusetts will also be up for adoption. The MSPCA's goal is to rehome more than 100 dogs over the course of this week.
Oh my goodness, give me all of them.
No, I want to take them all in. Like, I'm not a big dog person, but I just, like, I want them to have a home.
I love dogs. I want all of the dogs. I want to save them all. Seeing stories like this breaks my heart.
Same.
Well, hopefully they find homes. Ella and I are going to keep talking about dogs, so when we come back to commercial or after commercial, we are going to go behind the scenes with a package. Stick with us.
And when I arrive at my destination, I am gonna kill Bill.
What?
Oh! Okay, cutting, cutting. Sorry, can we get some of this light?
Where in God's name is the gaffer's tape?
Hi, I'm Nate.
And I'm Casey, and we're the National Broadcasting Society.
Come out to some of our weekly workshops, or work on some of our sets.
Explore the bigger picture with NBS.
We'll see you there.
All right, let's get another take. Camera, sound.
So yeah, it's like Emerson's very own late night talk show. We've got games, like Jimmy Fallon, and we're hot, like Jimmy Kimmel, and we've got guests. I'm gonna talk to them. You can talk too, I guess. There's a live studio audience, and they're just gonna laugh at everything we say, and it's gonna be awesome. It's just this never-ending cycle of positivity and community and late night content. I'm gonna wear a suit. You should probably wear one too. What do you think?
I think you should drink up, because it's closing time.
Emerson. So I know we've already talked about it a lot, but the marathon is just such a big event in Boston, and I feel like you can just never talk about it enough.
No, you're so true. On that note, WEBN actually went to Boston's 5K on Saturday in preparation for the marathon. Aaron Palacios was on the scene. We're going to take a look at it now.
Just 2 days before the Boston Marathon, people are gearing up for a lighter race, the Boston 5K.
The race was full of energy, split into multiple waves, and spanned across some of Boston's most iconic sites. And if you're not a runner, there's still ways to be involved. Volunteers Caitlin and Allison may not be participating in the race, but they certainly feel the excitement in the air.
Well, I think it's such an amazing event that Boston holds every year, and it's kind of nice to feel connected to the city.
I volunteered at a few races before in other cities, and I just think there's not an environment like this anywhere else. It's just really nice to be around other people who are celebrating.
And for those who are running, what gets them through those miles is close to the heart.
So my dad has cancer, and I just wanted to raise money for cancer and kind of, I don't know, just something for him.
Though not everyone is here for just the 5K. People like Eric are using the 5K as a warm-up.
I'll be running a marathon on Monday. And so the 5K was just like the tune-up, but I mean, it was just amazing. And it's like, it's just amazing. It's bigger than life.
For WEBN, I'm Aaron Palacios.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for that package, WEBN.
Yeah, that was amazing. Let's keep the sports energy going. We're going to head across the street to the Bobby Brown Gym with Max Lasky, who is going to talk even more about the marathon because we cannot get enough. How are you this morning, Max?
Hi, Caroline and Ella. I'm good. I'm feeling great. Caught the marathon yesterday. Did you two make it out to see the
Yeah, I made it out. I watched from like the 1 mile left mark by Fenway.
Oh, you're by Fenway. No, right downtown. I mean, the finish line is so close to campus. You can't miss it.
No, you can't. Where'd you watch it, Max?
I was actually at the finish line. So I was like right there up front, got some cool pictures, had a really nice time, got some coffee. It was a great experience.
As you should, and it was a really nice day, so yeah. I'm glad that everyone got a good experience there. But we're going to pass it over to you now, Max, who can give us the updates this weekend of sports.
Thanks, Caroline and Ella. Helen Obiri made history yesterday as she won the Boston Marathon for the second consecutive year. Obiri is the first back-to-back winner since Catherine Ndereba won two straight races in 2004 and 2005. Obiri's milestone is sensational for many reasons, but what's most fascinating is that this was Obiri's third win in just four marathons total. The 128th Boston Marathon was a sight to behold, and as the countdown for the 129th edition of the race starts, can Obiri go for a three-peat? We'll have to wait till next year to find out. Whose house? Clark's house. The biggest star in all of college sports, Caitlin Clark, is heading to play for the WNBA Indiana Fever. And the Iowa Hawkeyes will honor the great one and retire her number 22 jersey. Clark did incredible things in college, perhaps her biggest achievement becoming the all-time leading scorer in NCAA men's and women's Division I basketball history. The 22-year-old will become the third Hawkeyes women's basketball player to have her jersey retired after Michelle Edwards and Megan Gustafson, number 22, will soon be in the rafters forever. For Scottie Scheffler took home first place this past weekend at the 88th Masters Tournament. For the second time in 3 years, Scheffler walks away with a Masters Championship, what is arguably the most coveted prize in all of professional golf. Scheffler became just the second player to win both the Masters and the Players' Championship in the same season, joining Tiger Woods. Scheffler will have a chance for more glory when the men's major circuit heads to Kentucky's Valhalla Golf Course next month for the PGA Championship. That's all I have for sports today. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thank you so much, Max. Now our entertainment correspondent, Sam Lawrence, is in the studio with us, so we are going to head over to him for an update on the 2021 Rust shooting.
Thank you, Caroline and Ella. Hannah Gutierrez-Reed, the armorer for the infamous Rust movie, was sentenced to 18 months in prison by a New Mexico judge this Monday for the death of Helena Hutchins, the film's cinematographer. Hutchins was killed after actor Alec Baldwin fired a live round at her while using a prop gun, which Reed had been charged with checking prior to use. The incident occurred over 2 years ago, and just last month, Reed was found guilty of involuntary manslaughter. The trial consisted of over 30 witnesses and a three-hour deliberation prior to her sentencing. Prosecutors claimed that Reed displayed a, quote, complete and total failure to accept responsibility for her actions. During this year's Coachella Music Festival, fans got to witness a wide variety of surprise performances. During Lana Del Rey's set list this past Friday, Billie Eilish came on stage and sang a duet of Lana's song, Video Games, as well as a rendition of her own song, Ocean Eyes. On that same day, Shakira made an appearance at Bizarrap's performance and revealed the title of her upcoming world tour, Las Mujeres Ya No Lloran. This is also the title of her newest studio album. And yesterday, Renee Rapp brought out pop superstar Kesha to sing her iconic song, TikTok, which was released almost 14 years ago. TikTok became Kesha's first number one song on the Billboard Hot 100 charts. And Ryan Gosling is officially parting ways with his iconic role as Ken from the hit live-action Barbie movie. In his monologue on Saturday Night Live this past weekend, Gosling performed a parody of Taylor Swift's song, All Too Well, in a ceremonious farewell to his beloved character. Gosling simultaneously used this monologue to usher in the next phase of his acting career. He is starring in a new Universal Studios film titled The Fall Guy, which will hit theaters in early May. Gosling's co-star in the upcoming film, Emily Blunt, also made an appearance during the monologue. She sang her own Oppenheimer-themed version of the song as she was nominated for Best Supporting Actress at this year's Academy Awards for her role as Kitty Oppenheimer. That's all I have today in entertainment. Back to you two at the desk.
Thank you, Sam. We're going to go ahead to a quick commercial break, but when we come back, we are going to get a political update from Noah Berkowitz. Stay tuned.
All right, come back in 10 seconds. Ready, camera one. Camera one, get a wide shot of the entire thing, and in 3, 2, 1, take it. Talent cue.
Welcome back to Emerson College. Emerson Trails.
Camera 4, get a shot of the players coming across the court.
10 seconds left. Emerson Trails by 1 point.
As camera 2, close up on the person shooting. Right.
Thanks, Joe. With 10 seconds left, Emerson is hoping to pull away and score this game.
Count 1, get a close up. Follow them over.
Emerson Trails WPI by 10 points. 10 seconds left. Emerson Trails by 1 point. As the team finishes their timeout.
Camera 1, close up on number 33.
Thanks, Joe.
Follow the ball, follow the ball.
Welcome back to Good Morning Emerson.
We're going to head right over to politics correspondent Noah Berkowitz, who has the latest about Supreme Court Justice Clarence Thomas. How are you this morning, Noah?
Hey, thank you guys. I'm doing well. So, missing in action, Supreme Court Justice Clarence Thomas missed oral arguments Monday and left no explanation. Chief Justice John Roberts said that Thomas would not be present after the rest of the court sat for arguments in a public corruption case. Thomas missed multiple arguments last year after being diagnosed with an infection. The court usually offers context as to why a justice will not be present, and oftentimes, if not in person, a justice will attend virtually. And New Hampshire Governor Chris Sununu said that he will support former President Trump despite believing he contributed to the January 6th insurrection. Sununu doubled down, saying that he would vote for Trump no matter what because of issues like border security and the economy. Support is a flip-flop, as Sununu campaigned for former GOP candidate Nikki Haley and even said Trump was, quote, not a real Republican. Sununu responded to a question from George Stephanopoulos asking if he'd support Trump if he's convicted in his Manhattan trial with, quote, me and 51% of America. The governor reaffirmed his belief that Trump attempted to overturn the election, but that it shouldn't be a surprise that he's endorsing Trump. And finally, an update on the Baltimore Bridge collapse. The FBI has formally opened a criminal investigation into the Francis Scott Key Bridge collapse. The investigation is said to be focused on what led up to the boat collision and whether all federal laws were practiced. Baltimore Mayor Brandon Scott has also partnered with two separate law firms to attempt to hold, quote, wrongdoers responsible. Investigators are focused on the electrical power system of the cargo ship. The ship did experience power issues shortly before the crash. The incident left six dead, with three bodies recovered and three more unaccounted for. That's all I have for politics today. Back to you guys at the desk.
Thank you, Noah.
Now, it was a big weekend at Emerson because it was the gala, the kickoff to EVVY season.
EVVYs Gala. I went. It was so, so fun and magical. I've never been to any of the EVVYs
before. Oh, it's a good time.
It was so fun. And our good friend, Megan Richards, who was our political correspondent.
Last season,
won an EVVY for an opinion article. And that was so lovely to watch.
Yes. And we still do have so many nominations for Good Morning Emerson coming in the spring in May at the Majestic, so we're looking forward, fingers crossed, for some wins.
EVVY family.
But in case you did miss the gala, it's your lucky day because we sent our entertainment correspondent Sam Lawrence to the show in case you missed everything, so let's check it out.
I'm Sam Lawrence. Welcome to the 43rd annual EVVYs Gala Red Carpet.
The EVVY season kicked off officially this weekend with its gala taking place Sunday night. EVVY's advisor Diana Barton met up with us on the red carpet to talk all about this year's awards.
And professors and staff and some of your favorite people, we hope, who will be giving out awards. And we've got plenty of them to give out, so it's going to be a fun, fun night.
Barton oversees the 100-plus crew of students who make the EVVYs possible.
Well, a lot of people don't know that it takes a year to get this show off the ground.
The gala serves as the first of two award ceremonies, which students coordinate. This year's gala was decked in red and sparkling lights, an effort contributed both by event agency VDA and Emerson students, perfectly fitting into this year's Old Hollywood theme. Hosts J.J. Moore and Darrell Mundane stole the show by introducing presenters and entertaining the audience throughout.
Oh! Who did that? Wait, who did that? Was it you? You? Who did it? Who did it? Darrell?
With big awards such as the Student Award of Distinction being handed out to senior Rob Burke, the event was filled with students being rewarded for their hard work. The EVVY season will come to an end on May 10th with its highly anticipated Cutler Majestic show.
Okay, guys, well, it is, I have to go inside, but thank you so much for watching.
Oh, no, well, I hope Sam is okay. They yanked him off pretty fast, but seeing as he was in studio today, I guess he's arrived.
Yes, maybe we should check on him.
No, yeah, well, as we check on Sam, we're going to head to a quick commercial break while Caroline and I figure out what
happened to Sam.
So stay tuned. But when we come back, the Treble Makers will be here to perform.
And when I arrive at my destination, I'm gonna kill Bill.
What?
Oh! Okay, cutting. Sorry, can we get some of this light?
Where in God's name is the gaffer's tape?
Hi, I'm Nate.
And I'm Casey, and we're the National Broadcasting Society.
Come out to some of our weekly workshops, or work on some of our sets.
Explore the bigger picture with NBS.
We'll see you there.
All right, let's get another take. Camera, sound.
So yeah, it's like Emerson's very own late night talk show. We've got games, like Jimmy Fallon, and we're hot, like Jimmy Kimmel, and we've got guests. I'm gonna talk to them. You can talk too, I guess. There's a live studio audience, and they're just gonna laugh at everything we say, and it's gonna be awesome. It's just this never-ending cycle of positivity and community and late night content. I'm gonna wear a suit. You should probably wear one too. What do you think?
I think you should drink up, because it's closing time.
Black Beatles in the city, be back immediately to confiscate the money.
Fresh girl.
That girl is a real crowd, please. Small world, all the friends know of me. Young bull living like an old geese. Quick release the cash, watch it fall slowly. Frat girl still trying to get in. Haters mad for whatever reason. Smoke in the air, binge drinking. They lose it when the DJ drops the knee.
Welcome back to Good Morning Emerson.
We are here with the Emerson College Treble Makers, who are about to perform the song Hypotheticals. Take it away, guys.
Obviously, we're at the beginning of something. I don't expect you to know where it's gonna go, but I believe we might be on to something, and I just thought maybe you should know. Hypotheticals in my mind, I've been writing your name down next to mine. Been imagining all the things you and I could do. I've seen all the possibilities in my dreams. You're alone and you should believe me next to me. Baby, let's not wait and see. Immediate action is unnecessary. It's a fatal attraction. It's a little scary. But I got a plan of attack, and I'll get us there someday soon. I know it. I got a plan A, and I got a plan B. And if it's absolutely necessary, we'll go to plan C. Whatever I gotta do to be with you. I've been playing out a lot of hypotheticals in my mind. I've been writing your name down next to mine. Been imagining all the things you and I could do. I've seen all the possibilities in my dreams. You're a lover and you should really be next to me. Baby, let's not wait and see. Nobody can see into the future, even the weatherman gets caught in the rain sometimes. But I see something in you that I've never seen before, and I can't be sure, no, maybe not, but I think it's worth the shot. Hypothetically, yes. Theoretically, forever. We'll see what happens, but I hope we will never be apart. Hypothetically, yes. Theoretically, forever.
We'll see what happens, but I hope we will never be apart. Hypothetically, yes, theoretically, forever. We'll see what happens, but I hope we will never be apart. Whoa, hypothetically, yes, theoretically, forever. We'll see what happens, but I hope we will never be apart. Playing out a lot of hypothetical lines. I've been writing your name down next to my eyes. Whoa, whoa.
I see all the possibilities in my dreams.
The possibilities. Whoa, yeah.
Let's not wait and see. Bop, da, da, da.
Oh my gosh.
That was so great, guys.
That was so awesome. Thank you guys for coming with us this morning. That is all we have for you. My name is Caroline Reese.
And I'm Ella Schaefer. Thanks for waking up with us.